to Painting with Ruth Bate, episode 3. So, carrying on with the same painting again as last time, and we're going to be listening this time to 3 albums. So we've got my first solo album, An Elephant in Must, which you can also listen to as separate tracks or as a full album here on my YouTube channel, or you can go to Bandcamp, where you can find Plato's House Records and listen to the rest of the music that me, my brother and Ben John Silver release. It's our record label. You can subscribe to it for £4 a month. That's basically if you've got loads of money. If you're one of those people with a really good job and you make a lot of money, subscribe to it because you get a load of music. We've made a lot of albums. I've got another 3 Ruth Bate albums, which I'm yet to release because I've been very, very slow. I've made a lot of music, but I haven't done much with it. You will have heard some of it live if you've been to my gigs, but I mix some Modern Blonde stuff in there with it as well because Modern Blonde don't play live. That's mostly just because my brother Adam, he just doesn't get why you would. Like, back in the day, we would, he hates it. We would be doing gigs, and he would, just out of nowhere, just kind of, like, because when you're doing a gig, the sound can sound great out there, but it can sound shit on stage, in the monitors. And if it wasn't sounding good to him, he would just stop. He'd say, oh, this is shit. There's no point, and then that would be the end of the gig. So stuff like that is why Modern Blonde don't play live. But we've been getting buff. Well, look, right. I don't look buff when I'm not buff anymore because I stopped getting buff when I started smoking again. That completely demotivated me. By the way, if I'm looking off camera, there's no reason. I just keep looking at my computer, but there's nothing on it. I was going to put Africa Cam on there, but I couldn't find it. Ah, that's because I searched Africa Mam. Let me see if I can just quickly get Africa Cam up there. Anyway, right, forget Africa Cam. But don't forget Africa Cam. I'm going to forget about putting Africa Cam up. I was going to have Africa Cam on, so I could just, if I wanted, look at some wildlife in Africa. My friend Brannan in college, he found a website where it's just someone had set up a camera on a tripod somewhere in Africa, just by a little stream or by a little like pond, and it's just a live stream cam of Africa, and you just watch it. Most of the time nothing was happening. Occasionally you might see a bird. I forgot why I'm talking about Africa Cam. Oh yeah, because I was looking over there. There's no reason. I was going to have Africa Cam up just for myself, just because I remembered it, and I thought that would be quite funny that I'm just looking at a live stream of somewhere in Africa, but I couldn't find it. If I do find it, I'll do it next time, and I'll put a link in the description so you can do the same if you want. You can watch me, this, and have Africa Cam up, and watch both at the same time, and then we'll be doing the same thing. But anyway, yeah. Oh, speaking of Africa, I discovered a new bird that I've never seen before called the shoebill stork. And that's shoebill because its bill looks like a shoe, like a 7-inch shoe, kind of like a clog. It's amazing. They could grow from 3 foot to 5 foot, and they look like a heron. But like a heron had a baby with a dodo. That's what they look like. I'm gonna put a picture up of a shoebill stork. That's what they look like. And yeah, I just thought I'd share that with you. So yeah, we'll get started. Oh no, we won't get started yet. And don't worry, there'll be if you're not interested in this little introduction, and you just want to see me get straight to the painting, There's I'm gonna put in the description little time markers so you can just skip the intro if you just want to get straight to the painting. I'm just spotting dog hairs on the thing. So yeah. Also, I've got the multicam option now because I'm using my phone, because I made my own little DIY phone stand, which I'm very proud of. I'm just gonna grab it because I want to show you. Look at that. I made that out of a coat hanger. Isn't that amazing? And it look, because it's wire, it's adjustable. So if I want a different angle, I just pull it out, but I'm gonna leave it at this angle because it's good for watching the dogs. But I got this set up just so I could film the dogs at the same time as I'm filming this. So if they do something funny, I can just pop it up on the screen somewhere. And then you'd be able to see what I'm talking about. And they're beautiful dogs. But look at that. Isn't that amazing? It's a beautiful phone stand. And I even added this bit so I could hook it on something if I wanted to mount it on a wall, and it works. So yeah, very proud of that. I'm gonna call my dad after this and tell him about the YouTube channel and stuff so he can watch me paint if he's interested, but more just so I can go, look at that, what I did. I'm gonna send him a photo. Plus I'm bad at getting in touch with people, and I said last time I was on the phone to him, I'll call you next time. And he said, I don't believe you. And I said, you're probably right, but he's gonna get a call before I call him. See, I keep looking over there, but there's no reason. You're there. I'll stop looking over there. But yeah, I'm new to this, so anyway, let's get going. Oh yeah, look what I've got today. Thought this would be fun. I've got some milk chocolate with jelly popping candy in it. I was thinking, because this microphone's so sensitive, you'll probably be able to hear the crackling in my mouth. So I wanted to see if that's the case. So I'm just gonna put a load of it in my mouth and then just bring my mouth close to the camera. We'll see if you can, if the mic picks it up. Also, because the mic is so sensitive, you'll be hearing music in the background, like now. That's dHexam scoring something. And there's nothing I can do about that. I'm not going to go in and say, could you put some headphones on? I'm doing this. That's more important, what she's doing. So, but if you're just wondering what's that in the background? Plus also, in the other videos, when I was watching it back, because the mic's so sensitive, I could hear, I kept thinking, what's going on? Is D cooking at this time? I fooled myself. That's how good the mic is, because I had it in headphones. It just sounded like noises were happening when they weren't. Oh yeah, sorry, I'm supposed to be getting close to the microphone. I love popping candy. Now. Right. I won't open my mouth or anything because I don't want to be disgusting. Actually, I might, but if I do, in the edit, I'll cover it up. Can you hear that? Right, sorry about this. This is too long of an introduction. It's not that kind of show. So let's get on with it. Oh yeah, sorry. I just need to tell you what we're gonna be listening to. So we're listening to my first album, An Elephant in Must, and then we're gonna be listening to Home Truths, which is technically it's not the first Modern Blonde album, but as far as you're concerned, it is, because we're never going to release our first album. And so we're going to listen to that straight after I've put them all in a playlist. And then after that, we're going to listen to Off the Chain, which is the next Modern Blonde album. So we're going kind of chronologically, chronologically through all the music that we've released. So that's three albums that we might get through in this, because I want this to be a bit longer, because I want to really get into the painting. So yeah. So this is Ruth Bate, An Elephant in Must. Praise the Walls, the first track. Let's go. Sorry, forgot something very important. That was basically what I was supposed to talk about in the intro, but then I got distracted thinking about Africa Cam and other stuff and the Shoebill Stalk. Where is it? Right, yeah. So this is a new YouTube channel. I've made it live. I've put it up now, so you can obviously you know that because you're watching this on it. But my first subscriber, John, bloody legend, subscribing. You get that. That's Modern Blonde Synth is Mint. John gets a prize for being the first subscriber. Synth is Mint. That's available still. Most of our music, we decided to stop doing physical copies because it's just expensive. But, we've still got physical copies of Synth is Mint. Mint basically is Manx slang for just really, really good. So Synth is Mint. So that's yours, John. Next time I see you, I'm gonna give you that for being a bloody legend and subscribing to the YouTube channel. I should have said that initially. First subscriber gets a mystery prize. And then I would have got more subscribers, maybe. But hey, it doesn't matter. But do subscribe. Definitely subscribe. Because what does. I don't see any downside of you subscribing to this. Don't click the little notifications. There's no point. Or do if you want, but like, I don't usually if I subscribe to something, because then you just get little pop-ups. But yeah. Anyway, right, let's get started. So John gets a prize. Looking for another brush. I think I'm missing a brush. I don't know what I've done with it. I don't know where it's gone. Is it rolled off? I don't know. Like Goldilocks. This one's too small and this one's too big. I want the one that's just right. There's this one, but it doesn't have a stick. I'm gonna use this one. Oh yeah, I realised when I was talking before, I got distracted, I think. What was I talking? I don't know what distracted me, but I was talking about, I was going to say, the buffness contest that me and my brother Adam were doing. He's pretty buff now, but it was smoking that stopped me, started smoking again that stopped me being buff. I know my arm looks very weedy, but that's also an optical illusion. It's a kind of fisheye lens to take in as much as possible. So I'm just going to give you that's what it's like. I'm going to optimize the fisheye so you really get a feel. I know that's not massive or anything, but it's not as puny as it looks when I'm like that. I'll put up a picture of me at my peak buffness now. Just a quick one, because I don't want you to look at that for too long. I was buffer than I am now, but I'm not as puny as this camera makes me look. I was doing I was going to a boxing gym and doing circuits, but that was so much fun. I loved that, with the punch bags and stuff. It's just really, really fun. So I want to get back into that once all this lockdown's over. But I was working out at home loads, and then, like I said, the smoking stopped me. It just really zaps my energy and makes me slow and sluggish. I'm trying to get by with the Juul. I bought a packet of cigarettes the other day, but I'm trying not to smoke them. I was stressed. But yeah, anyway, back to the painting.
Thank you.
brushy shit. This blue ultramarine, it feels different to the other paints. Do paints have an expiration date? Just seems a bit more watery. Thank you. that's the kind of style of Tower of Babel that I want to put here. Well, like it burning, like it's crumbling down. I had quite a clear version of it at one point, and then I painted over it because I just want to mess it up a bit more. Like, because if you have seen the first two videos, or especially the first one, or even if you just look at the thumbnail for it, you might go, oh, it was better then, you shouldn't have done, you shouldn't have done any of this. But it didn't feel like it felt when I was there, so I want to create the feeling. And that's what I like about art, you can see feelings. So that's what I'm trying to do, is create the feeling. But it feels like I'm just wasting time now, just adding more blue. It feels like I need to actually get into the more difficult stuff. So that's what I'm going to do next. Bear with me. Hello again. Welcome back. I know that I went somewhere, you didn't. You might have. But I was distracted because I was craving cigarettes. I've got some, like I said, though I'm trying not to smoke them. It was just on my mind, it was distracting me from the painting, so I had one. And I just didn't want to do it on the camera, because if anyone else is trying to quit smoking and they're watching this, I know it's really, if you see someone smoking on screen, you're like, why can they smoke and I can't? That's what's in my head whenever I see someone smoking. So I don't want to put the idea in anyone else's head, even though I probably have by explaining I shouldn't have said anything. I've been using the Juul, but I just want to stop that as well. So I got the lower nicotine little things to put in it, and they it's just not as good now. But anyway. It was never good. Oh yeah, this is something I wanted to ask you. If you're watching this, are you watching it on a phone or on a computer? Like, because I see this as more as a desktop experience. But if you are watching it on your phone, just write in the comments, if you don't mind, just say, yeah, I watched it on my phone. Oh, another thing I want to know, I can't figure it out, and Dee doesn't know what it is. I've got an earworm, but I don't know any of the lyrics, or who it's by, or anything. All I know is just what it's like. So I'll try and do it for you now. And then if you know what that is, write it in the comments, because it's doing my head in. I tried to Shazam me doing this, and it didn't, obviously didn't work. But it's like this. Hang, no, it's higher than that. Hang, Jerry, so ring, ding, ding. Hang, Jerry, ding, 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 ding. Hang, Jerry, so ring, ding, ding. Hang, Jerry, so ring, ding, ding. Hang, ding, 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 ding. Just like that. If you know exactly what that is, please tell me. In the comments, just write that song that you did. It's this. I think it's the Bee Gees, just because of the hing, ring, ping, ring, ding, ding, and sharing, ring, ding, ding. I really want to listen to it because I know that I enjoy it, but I don't know what it is. Anyway, let's get back to the painting. I've been talking more in this one than I have in the others, if that's annoying. Write that in the comments, or if you know me, just say, don't talk as much in it. Oh, plus if you know me, just send me a message and say if you know what that song is and tell me. We'll go back to An Elephant in Must. That's the title, by the way. If you don't know what An Elephant in Must is, watch a documentary called The Dark Side of Elephants. It's on YouTube, and I've been trying to find it for years. I watched it a long time ago, and it's brilliant. And basically, when an elephant's in must, it's the male elephants, the ones that have tusks, they go through a thing called must, where like this super crazy oil comes out of their temples and it ends up going into their mouths. But they're like testosterone crazy and they just want to dominate everything and destroy, and they go bonkers and basically go crazy, and they tusk the ground to kind of alleviate the pain in the heads. Love elephants. But watch that documentary, it's amazing. I think it's only like 45 minutes long. It's National Geographic, so it'll probably be on Disney Plus as well if you got that. But yeah, that's great. Just drinking a Tenzing. I love Tenzings, and this is a new flavour, and it's bigger than the usual Tenzings. It's natural ingredients, purely from plants, blueberry and acai, I think that is. But it's got BCAAs in it as well, which the others don't usually have. And like I say, it's bigger. But they're great. It's based on what Sherpa Tenzing drank going up Everest. I might make a segment called What's Ruth Drinking Today? Because that's something that I started doing with some of my friends during lockdown. It was What's Tom Drinking Today? Because that's my name, Tom. But my artist name is Ruth Bate. So it'd be What's Ruth Drinking Today? I just have all these images with a little avatar of me just telling them what I'm drinking, and I'd make a funny video and stuff. The only downside is I'd love to do that as one of my new sections on my YouTube channel, but the funniest ones is when I found like a track to play or like a music video, and then I'd have the can like propped up in front of the screen, but you can't do that on YouTube. I don't want to get my channel taken down. No, I love it so much. Just for jokes. But yeah, let's get back to it. Want to use this brush, but I mustn't have washed it last time I used it. It's a bit stiff, so I'm just trying to.
Thank you.
So that's the end of Ruth Bate and Elephant in Must. Now we're on to Home Truths by Modern Blonde.
Thank you.
Happy birthday if it's anyone's birthday. This tensing's really nice. By the way, just in case you think, like, oh, he seems really into this whole YouTube thing now. This isn't my attempt of like me thinking this is how you make money off YouTube, is like you just go like, love this drink, love this drink that I'm drinking. Love it. It's the best. I just do like it. Oh, actually, here's a good bit of promotion for cash. Pot noodle, right? I've been eating pot noodles recently because I've been trying to be productive and just save time, like, on like cooking. So like I'll just have a pot noodle during the day because it's really quick. And inside the lid, we'll use this one. It says less time cooking, more time chasing your dreams. Hashtag you can make it. And the first time I saw that, I was like, that's so fucking annoying. I genuinely hate adverts. If there are adverts on this, by the way, and it's something I haven't done on YouTube, I'll figure that out. So hopefully there's no adverts, but I don't even know if that's possible or if you just need to get ad blocker, because I've got ad blocker on my computer, so I don't see them on YouTube. But yeah, so I despised that. There's another one. Use your noodles, save time and chase your dreams. Hashtag you can make it. Just imagine them sitting around in a boardroom going like, all these advertisers, like young advertisers. I imagine this is like young advertising people like going like, so what's unique about pot noodles? Like, saves time, like just brainstorming, going like, yeah, this, that. What is it? Saves time? It's like, yeah. Saves time, yeah, that's something. You're on something. So if you can save time with pot noodle, what does it give you time to do? Chase your dreams. Hashtag you can make it. And I found that really irritating and then realized that's exactly why I'm eating pot noodles, is to save time, to chase my dreams. Like, this is my dream, doing this. So I'm not gonna diss it. Eat a pot noodle, chase your dreams. It's gross though, isn't it? My favourite pot noodle flavour is chicken and mushroom. It's the only one I ever get. I don't get the beef tomato one. I don't get the curry one. Ever. It's the only, I don't think I've even ever tried another pot noodle. I think I've tasted another pot noodle. I was like, chicken and mushrooms,
lovely.
There's two swans that live on this. That live on this little man-made lake. And I think I'm gonna paint them in. Paint them in the lake.
Just a good wine and a little soul of us today.
I'm liking this, this feels good. Going up to the toilet, but with that song, just what I remembered something. I used to have a counsellor, like the time I was doing this music, and she was blind, and I would talk about my music a lot, and then I remember I said to her one time, "Do you want to hear it?" And she's like, "Yeah, sure." So she put the headphones on, and she was listening to it, and I could kind of hear the bleed from the headphones, so I knew where it was up to. And that bit where it goes, "He remembers your face," that's like the kind of moment of the song. Like, she went like this, And it was just like, yeah, it was a great moment. She got it, she dug it. But yeah. Hey. Gunter's come in, so I've got to use the dog cam. I'll have to get a different coloured sheet for that little bed they're on, though, because I don't know if you can even see him. He kind of blends into it because he's golden coloured. But Rutger's in with D. I just had a listen to the score she's doing. It sounds mint. Hey, Gunter. Gunter. Hey, fella. That's it. You can see you now. Sorry, you can go back to bed. You go back to sleep. He's so cute. I've never known a dog to get so many kisses from women. Love him. Like, they'll start stroking him and they just get like sucked in. They just want to kiss him. You get so many kisses. And like other little dogs, they always go for his penis, but it's like they lock onto it. It's like, it's like a drug, and they just keep sniffing it and licking it. Sometimes it gets ridiculous, and other dog's owner's like, "All right, now come on," and like calling it and doing whistles and everything, and just, they're just following him, and he doesn't seem to like that too much, but he doesn't mind the kisses from the women. He prefers humans to dogs. He's a bit antisocial with dogs. So we keep him on the lead most of the time. That's great when you can get them both running around together. They're so fast. Right, back to it. I really hope the dog cam works. If you're watching this video and a dog cam doesn't appear, like now, I'll be well pissed off, because I think I've figured it out.
I found you so.
press one. Not this brush. I don't know if that's too small for you to see. That's shit. See me like when I'm wiping the thing, that's me getting dog hairs off the canvas. So they shed a lot. But I like having them in here. This feels more like a swan already. It's that line.
Oh.
trepidatious now. That looks good, but it needs a little beak, and you just need to get that kind of, you know, like a swan's head, like the beak's there, and then its temple almost comes out a little bit. That's the swan. I think his body needs a bit of work, but swan done. I'm trying to figure out if I should do two swans or one swan. I feel like its body needs to be a little bit bigger. this feels right whenever I'm adding the black with the white. Feels like it unifies the water with the sky, with the whole mood. I have a feeling that this painting is going to take forever though. This whole area, see it more clearly on the first video, but it's all fenced in, just a plot of land that's fenced in. I think that's important, so I'm going to try and kind of use the snow to be kind of for a little bit, Modern Blonde were managed by Lindsay Reed, And she got Jeff Travis from Rough Trade Records to come and see us. We did a gig in London and we did that song in the set list. And it was just a bad set list, and I don't think it was a good gig, but he walked out after like four songs. Hated it. He said, "I don't know what you see." Yeah. Jeff Travis is not a Modern Blonde fan. Doesn't like it. I was just thinking about What's it about Lindsay Reeb when she managed us? I have no idea how that ended. I don't know how she stopped being our manager. It was dead messy time for us all, kind of mental health wise. I know, like, we're all working in a nightclub. So, like, I remember when you were working in the nightclub in winter, I remember you just didn't see the sun, didn't see daylight for like months, because you'd be sleeping through the day, through the hours, like that there would be some sun, and by the time you got up it was dark, and you'd go to work, go home. Working in a nightclub is grim, very grim. But I just genuinely can't remember what happened, but I imagine like we were dicks in some way. Didn't mean to be, though. But she was so nice. Really nice woman. Nice person. But yeah, it'd be nice to get in touch with her. See how she's doing. But yeah. I think that was the last, yeah, that's the last track off Home Truths. And then we're on to Off the Chain. I think what it was partly was we'd done the first album and she was like, yeah, it's really good, so let's try and push it. And we'd already got well into writing Home Truths, and it was kind of a change of style. I think she just tried, like a good manager, just get us to focus and focus on the album that we'd done. But that's what we're like, we're always like, all right, that's done, I just want to do the next one now. And we're very naive. We still are, you know, in a lot of ways. But I think it was something like that. We were kind of past the first album, so I think we were quite difficult like that. We weren't like proper, well, we weren't bad or anything. We were just a little bit weird. Just not quite right. But gonna take a break for a minute and I'll be back. Hello again. So this next album, yeah, Off the Chain. Oh yeah. Just want to say thank you to the Black Box as well. That's a gig venue in Belfast. It's meant really good. They've always been very supportive of me, like ever since I moved to Belfast. And they reposted my thing on Instagram about my YouTube channel. So I just want to say thank you. Still drinking Tenzing, but I'm drinking it out of my Nicolas Cage mug.
Oh.
I love Ben's guitar playing. It's so good. Fucking great. Hey, guitar. Gunter was dubious of the phone stand that I made. He was scared of it. Go for a pee. Back in a sec. By the way, just so you know, if I'm ever doing like this, it's just to stretch because I have a habit of having bad posture. It just feels nice. I'm not trying to, you know. I saw I've had to watch a lot of YouTube tutorials and videos of how to set stuff up, and there was a guy who's very obviously just going yeah, so. When I was, and he had like big arms, but you could tell he was fully doing that. I like listening to my own music, but I want to listen to something else, but I can't because I would like usually if I was painting, I might listen to my own music for a bit, but I'd probably be listening to something else. Like, I'm in the mood to listen to Scott Walker. Do you like Scott Walker as much as I do? He's the best.
Memories come. Thank you.
Come on, Rutger. You join in. Thought we might be getting Rutger in. Gather in that last song, I was in a very bad place when I was doing this. There we go. I've struggled with depression for a long time. It seems to be just like a chemical thing. It seems to run in my family a lot. I was on medication for ages for it, but so there's some of them that felt like they worked for a little bit, but maybe a bit too much. Like I was like really up, like really high, but it would help for a bit and then it would stop working and then you'd up the dose and then eventually just none of them worked and the side effects were horrible. And eventually I managed to come off them just because the side effects were really bad. There he is. Hello, big man. I don't know if the dog cam's still on. I think maybe the phone ran out of battery. It's probably draining the battery loads. You missed the dog cam, Rutger. Mr. Duncan. You'll go settle down on the bed. Do you want me to make a space for you? Don't hit the tripod. Duh. No. Right, bear with me a sec. Hey, so the dog cam's set up. It's pretty underwhelming, because though I'm very proud of my phone stand, it's, naturally it's supposed to be at a slight angle, so it's kind of looking up. And they're on a bed that kind of sinks in, because it's like a camp bed. There's some action. You can see Rook kind of just biting his thigh. So yeah, anyway, they'll just pop up if they're doing anything interesting. But we might just scrap the dog cam because I had to delete a load of stuff off my phone in order to be able to film for long enough. But hey. So yeah. I don't know if I'm about done for the day. I don't know if I've got much more to do. I need to add me in the mastering at some point, but I kind of want to get that camera set up as well, so that I'll film that. So then we'll have three cameras. So I think maybe the next one I'll try start adding this, but I'm still not quite getting the, it's getting there, but it's not quite the look that I've got in my head. Look in my head is, I think it's just gonna take so many layers to get what I'm aiming for. That's good, Rutger. That's very good for the dog cam. I'm gonna give Gunter a pillow just for the dog cam to do its job, and he likes having a pillow. Let's give you one of my pillows. Pop that under here for you. So you still got your silky smooth quilt. Sorry, fella, I know. You try to chill. Is that nice? You like a pillow, don't you? Good boy. You're a big sexy beast. You're gorgeous. Right. Let's see. It is what it is, eh? It is what it is. Let's carry on with the music and do some more painting. Let's do it. Oh. thinking that would be a good time to say goodbye because it's the last track. We've listened to the three albums. But what I just did there, however I did that, I like the look of it. So I'm going to do a bit more. And since we've potentially got the dog cam up, should probably just keep going for a bit. I don't know how long this has been going on for, quite a while. That playlist is 2 hours and 9 minutes, and I've paused it quite a few times. It's good before Roe Jogan length. Not much going on the dog cam. What do I wanna do? What do I wanna do? What do I wanna play? We just keep going through the albums. I think we should mix it up. I'll play you some of the North Korean propaganda music that I'm working on. Thank you. So this North Korean propaganda music album, it's all, it came about through when I started, I used to make music on Cubase, and then I got Dee's old Mac, she upgraded her system, so I bought that off her rather than her, you know, selling it to someone else. And it had Logic on it, and I started using software instruments, and I'd always wanted to try, you know, like layering up loads of parts. Usually I'd do one part then another and layer it up like that, but being able to create all these software instruments and affect them and make them complement each other and play them all at the same time, really fun, in using the MIDI instruments, because I never used to use MIDI, but being able to use like these kind of fake software instruments that sounded convincing and fake at the same time, like you knew it was supposed to be a real instrument and you knew what the instrument was, but it wasn't quite convincing, kind of lacked some soul. And I made a track and it just sounded to me like North Korea, and then I decided that I'd make an album. I'm gonna do a series of videos on the North Korea album, kind of the making of it. I've got an idea for a kind of introduction video to it, which would be fun. But next, I think I've got Spring 2020, which I played some of in the last one, and then I've got this North Korean propaganda music album, and then I've got Ruth Bate and the Angels, which, and Through the Wall as well, and they're all unreleased. So there's four new Ruth Bate albums, and so next is going to be Through the Wall, then it'll be North Korean propaganda music, then Ruth Bate and the Angels. I think I might just release Spring 2020, maybe in Spring 2021. So yeah, but these are just demos at this stage. There's still a lot I want to do with them. Some of them are pretty there, but for example, this track is quite long, and I like it, but I want there to be a little bit more in there. So the concept of the album is that North Korea have got in touch with me and asked me to make propaganda music for them. And I'm trying to, within the album, kind of use the sonic qualities of fake instruments to speak to the fakeness of the situation over there. But I'd like to do American propaganda music as well, kind of inspired by Harold Pinter Nobel Prize lecture. You should check that out. Go on YouTube, turn this off, go on YouTube, type in Harold Pinter Nobel Prize lecture. Watch that. It's bonkers. It's very scary, but also feels very important. Basically just talks about how America is just able to spin itself as like the leader of the free world, but the way it acts internationally is basically the opposite. Thank you. song that was inspired by the movements of the traffic warden, not traffic wardens, I don't know what you call them actually, the ladies who direct the traffic. Like they move in very like little clockwork people, like when you see them from above, and the way they move around, the way they walk, it's all so regimented. Oh yeah, I wanted to say before Rutger came in, wanted to say about, I think I was talking about being on medication for a while. I know people that it works really well for, you know what I mean, where like medication, like antidepressants is amazing and like helps a lot, but I also know it can be really hard and it doesn't quite do what it's supposed to, and the side effects can be really bad. Like, I was never suicidal previous to taking antidepressants, but it feels like they kind of gave me a lack of inhibitions where that started becoming it became a big thing, where it was like, I take 5-HTP now, and you can get it at like Holland and Barrett, or just, you know, it's an amino acid, and it's really good. For me, it just works. You don't have to take it every day, it has no real side effects. It just helps you produce serotonin. And it really just does the job for me. Because when I tried it, I had no kind of faith that it would work. Because you think when you feel that bad, that like, how could it? You know what I mean? When you have depression for a long time, you attach it to basically everything, your whole worldview. And honestly, within about 40 minutes, because I was off my medication, just because I couldn't take it, and I was starting to lose hair and stuff, and just sweating profusely so much, and I just wanted to try being off it again. And then before long, I just started feeling really bad. And then I tried 5-HTP, and it's worked ever since. I just always have it, and I take it like, so if I don't feel good, I'll take it. I take 2 tablets, and then I just feel it just levels me out. If you take it before going to bed as well, you have mental dreams, like proper mental. Like I took it quite late last night. Oh, not last night, the night before. And my dreams were just absolutely bonkers. I used to like having like bonkers dreams, but I don't anymore. I prefer not to dream or not to remember any dreams. Just because it feels like you're going to bed to get to sleep and just kind of switch off. It feels like if you're dreaming really vivid dreams, it's like you don't get a break. Especially if you have like lucid dreams, which I did for a while. That always to me sounded like so much fun. But it just gets really tiring. Like I was waking up feeling tired, like I haven't been to sleep. But I don't really get that with the 5-HTP too much, just your dreams will be quite vivid if you take them just before going to bed. So I take mine kind of in the day. Mostly. I like these 2 brushes though. I've never done this before. Oh, it's getting there. This music's really good to paint too. Thank you. That's good, paint in tempo. Thank you. No. Well, have a good day, night, morning. Lots of love. Bye bye.